Good stuff.
Coming out.
Oh. We are back once again in the science room. We have lots of stuff in front of us. Dr. Nate.
Dr. Nate.
Exactly what I was thinking. Please explain what we are doing today.
I thought we would explore what happens when you eat your breakfast. I hear you like to have a big breakfast in the morning, so I thought I'd bring it for you here. Mini rolls, do you like mini rolls?
I like mini rolls.
Would you
rolls.
Mind just eating a mini roll for me? Eat that delicious mini roll and stop! What happened there, Max? Did you see what happened?
Teeth! He chomped!
He chomped, he used his teeth. Can you grab those scissors and chop up those mini rolls for me into the bowl in front of you? You had some bananas, right?
Bananas.
Okay, so you had a couple of bananas. Each one of you could peel a banana and chop that up.
I like to have the skin in my banana.
No, you don't want to have the skin in your banana.
No,
otherwise it's going to make the experiment go very wrong.
Okay.
Get that banana in there. Did you have beans this morning?
Yeah, beans.
I did have beans this morning. I bought a can of beans for you. Harvey still not swallowed, that's good to know.
Beans.
All right, so you also had toast, I heard. Did you have toast? How many slices?
About 18, but 18. For this purpose,
we'll just do three. I don't know whether you're coffee drinkers, but I really need to have a strong coffee in the morning.
Unfortunately, I'm not, but we'll do the coffee for you.
Yeah, let's put the coffee in. Okay, Harvey, what would you do next? Chew. You'd use your molars to squish up the food, which is what the potato mash is for.
This,
Max, mash away. Give that a really good mash.
this is grim. Let's get some skin
in there.
But where does it go next? When you swallow, what happens next?
Throat
into...
Stomach.
Stomach, exactly. So there is a plastic bag there. If you want to grab that plastic bag.
There we go.
Right.
In the bag it goes.
So the stomach is a really powerful organ. Not only is it filled with acids and other things to break down your food, but it's really muscly in it.
Oh.
Really mixes it around and churns it up. So if you give that a good churn, keep churning it around. So once that is all churned up in your stomach, then it has to go somewhere else. It goes into your intestines. First one being your small intestine, which I'm representing here with a pair of tights.
Okay, here we go.
Let's go in.
Beautifully
done.
All out.
All in there, get it all in. So the small intestine is where all the good stuff comes out, all of those nutrients. So what I need you to do is absorb some of those nutrients. Grab the top of it and push it down.
No, that's on you. I did the eating.
Come on, you can go. Look at all that good stuff coming out. Keep going. You've got to get all that good stuff. So that's the nutrients, the carbohydrates to give you energy. That's the fats to give you energy, but also support you. The proteins to help you get big and strong. So to represent the next stage, which is the large intestine, I've got a towel to dry out that food, to get as much of that water out as possible.
Listen, Nate, I think we're still going with it. Keep it going, because there's a lot more in there.
So it travels from the small intestine, now it has to go into the large intestine.
Yeah, Harvey, you can do this. This is really weird.
There we go. Beautiful work. Look at it go.
Nice.
We've got to get as much water out of that as possible. So could you dry that lovely bit of food a bit harder, you know, give it a good squish, get as much water out as possible. Remember, this is fun.
Yeah, I'm having so much fun.
Now, the rectum is the last stage on the intestinal journey, the journey of your breakfast. You can do it. I believe in you.
Sorry.
Okay, loading rectum. I feel like I'm going to drop this. Hang on. Oh my gosh, there it is, yeah.
You can tell when your rectum starts to fill because of a certain feeling. Do you know what that feeling is?
Indigestion.
Yeah. You need a poo. So what I need you to do is cut the end off that beautiful piping bag and show us your poo. Now, let's see, a bit closer up. You've seen this done on Bake Off, haven't you?
This does not get done on Bake Off.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm disgusted in all of us.
At least we now know how the digestive system works.
This is true.
I'm very knowledged now on, I should work on my grammar next time, but I know how the digestive system works. So thank you, Dr. Nate. Say goodbye.
Bye.
Did it normally.